This is Margaret and welcome to my YouTube channel Grammar Buzz, Learning Made Easy. Hey, thanks for joining me today. Today, we are going to learn about some more important rules of subject-verb agreement. But before we move on with the main part of the lesson, you already know what. Let us quickly know about the lesson objectives. And the lesson objectives today aims at helping us to know the rules of subject-verb agreement and also know their correct use. But before we start with the lesson, let us quickly recapitulate what we have already learnt in our previous video. Well, we have already learnt that for making a sentence grammatically correct, the subject of the sentence must agree with the verb in number. This means both the singular and the plural subject must take a singular and a plural verb. And you know what? That is the general and basic rule of subject-verb agreement. And together with this, we have also learnt that nouns and verbs form their plurals in different ways. Nouns add an S to the singular to form their plural, like one dog, which is singular, and many dogs, which is plural. But verbs, unlike nouns, remove S from the singular form to form their plural, like eats, which is singular, and eat, which is plural. Now let us try to understand the important rules of subject-verb agreement. And let us begin with the first one, that is the use of collective nouns. Well, what is collective nouns? You see, collective noun is the name of group of people, animal or things taken as one whole. For example, family, class, pack, flock, group, bunch and so on. And you need to remember that collective nouns generally take singular verbs when they are considered as singular units. Yes, this is the rule. Collective nouns generally take singular verbs because they are considered as singular unit. And now let us try to understand this rule with the help of an example. And our example sentence says, the group meets every week. The group meets every week. In this sentence, the subject group is a collective noun which is considered as a singular subject and so it agrees with the singular verb meets. Well, let us take a look at the following example. And it states, the family went to Los Angeles for vacation. The family went to Los Angeles for vacation. Here, the family is a collective noun considered as a singular subject and so we use the singular verb went with it. But you see, there is an exception to this rule too. And what is it? Well, you see, we use plural verbs if the members of the group are acting as individuals. Let us try to understand this with the help of an example. And our example sentence states, the family are each going to a different destination. The family are each going to a different destination. As per the sentence, we can understand that all the members of the family are not up to the same task. They are not going to the same destination. Each one is going to a different destination. As they are not working as a singular unit, we have used the plural verb are in this sentence. So remember, for collective nouns, use a singular verb when the members of the group are working together as a singular unit. And we use a plural verb when the members of the group are not working as a single unit. Isn't that simple to follow? I bet it is. Now, let us move on with the next rule. And our next rule states the use of gerunds. Well, what about gerunds? So, before we need to know the use of gerunds, it is important for us to know what are gerunds. Well, gerunds are the ing form of verb used as nouns. Gerunds are the ing form of verbs used as nouns. For example, running, eating, swimming, standing, sitting, and so on. So, when gerunds are used as subjects of a sentence, they take the singular form of the verb. Remember, when gerunds are used as subjects of a sentence, they take the singular form of verb. However, when they are linked by and, they take the plural form. But when gerunds are linked by the word and, they take the plural form. Now let us understand this rule with the help of some examples. And our example sentence says, standing in the water was a bad idea. Standing in the water was a bad idea. As per the sentence, we can understand that standing is a gerund in the sentence that has been used as the subject of the sentence. And so, a singular verb was is used in the sentence. But what about the next example? And it states, swimming in the ocean and playing drums are my hobbies. Swimming in the ocean and playing drums are my hobbies. Note in this sentence, there are two gerunds, swimming and playing. And both the gerunds are linked by the word and. So you remember that when two gerunds are linked by the word and, they usually take a plural verb. And so we have used a plural verb are in this sentence. So remember, when gerunds are used as subjects of a sentence, they take the singular form of verb. However, when two gerunds are linked by and in the same sentence, they take a plural form of verb. Well, well, moving on with our next rule. And it states the use of infinitives. Now, what about infinitives? Before we get to know the use of infinitives, we surely need to know what are infinitives, isn't it? So, let us know what are infinitives. Well, the infinitive is the base form of verb. You know what? The root form of verb without any additions? Yes, they are called infinitives. For example, run, eat, swim, sleep, and so on. So, when infinitives are used in the subject of a sentence, they take the singular form of verb. Remember, when infinitives are used as the subject of a sentence, they take the singular form of verb. However, if two infinitives are separated by and, they take the plural form of verb. Remember, if two infinitives are being separated by the use of word and, they take the plural form of verb. Let us now try to understand this with the help of some examples. And our first example sentence is, to sing is her hobby. To sing is her hobby. As per the sentence, we can understand that to sing is an infinitive that has been used in the sentence as the subject. And so, we use a singular verb is in the sentence. But what about our next example? And that is, to walk and to chew gum require great skill. To walk and to chew gum require great skill. Note in this sentence, both the infinitives to walk and to chew are separated by the word and so they take a plural verb require. So remember, when infinitives are used as the subject of the sentence, they take the singular form of verb. However, if two infinitives are separated by and, they take the plural form of verb. Good job! And we move on with our next rule. That is, the use of here and there in a sentence. Well, with here and there in a sentence, we use the general rule of subject-verb agreement. That is, with singular subjects we use singular verb and with plural subjects we use plural verb. Now let us try to understand this with the help of some examples. And our example sentence says, here are the papers you requested. Here are the papers you requested. For the plural subject papers, we have used the plural verb are. Isn't that simple? But what about this example? It states, there is a problem with the refrigerator. There is a problem with the refrigerator. Here, for the singular subject refrigerator, we have surely used the singular verb is. So remember, sentence beginning with here and there, we use singular verb with singular subject and plural verb with plural subject. And moving on with our next rule, and that is the use of distance, measurement and time period. The use of distance, measurement and time period. Well, let us see what is the meaning of this rule. All you need to remember is we use the singular verb form with the use of distance, units of measurement and time period. So let us consider an example. And our example sentence states, 4 quarters of oil was required to get the car running. 4 quarters of oil was required to get the car running. Well, we have used the singular verb was, as 4 quarter is considered as a singular unit of measurement. Moving on with the next example, and it says, the park is 2 miles walk from here. The park is 2 miles walk from here. Well, you see, in this sentence too, we have used the singular verb is in the sentence, as 2 mile is considered as a singular unit of measurement. Well, isn't that easy to remember? So, here comes our next rule. And it states, some nouns are always plural. These nouns have 2 parts, so they take plural verbs. It's as simple, you see. Some nouns are always plural. These nouns have 2 parts, so they take plural verbs. Some nouns like scissors, shorts, eyeglasses, pants, tongs, jeans, trousers have 2 parts and they are considered as plural. So remember, they always take plural verbs. Now let us consider the example. And our example sentence says, my jeans are in the closet. My jeans are in the closet. In the example, the noun jeans has 2 parts to it and it is considered as a plural subject. So it takes a plural verb and that is are in the sentence. Well, what about the next example? And that is, the scissors are blunt. The scissors are blunt. Well, you see, in this sentence too, the noun scissors has 2 parts to it and it is considered as a plural subject and so it uses a plural verb, that is are, in the sentence. So remember, some nouns like scissors, shorts, eyeglasses, pants, tongs, jeans, trousers are always plural and they always take the plural verb. And here we move on with our next rule. And what does it state? Well, it states, titles of books, movies, novels are treated as singular and take a singular verb. Titles of books, movies, novels are treated as singular unit and they always take a singular verb. So, let us consider our example sentence. And it says, Castaway is a movie starring Tom Hanks. Castaway is a movie starring Tom Hanks. In this sentence, Castaway is the title of the movie and it is treated as a singular subject. So, it uses a singular verb is in the sentence. Hey, isn't that simple for you to remember? Surely it is. And with this, we move on with our next rule. And that states, when noun and pronoun subjects like some, half, none, more, or all are followed by a prepositional phrase, Then the object of preposition determines the form of verb. Remember, when nouns and pronouns, subjects like some, half, none, more or all, and are followed by prepositional phrases, then the object of preposition determines the form of verb. And you know what? There are two structures to this rule. Let us consider both of them one by one. But before we get to know the rule, you need to know and understand what is a prepositional phrase. The word looks too heavy, isn't it? But it simply means a group of words consisting of a preposition. Yes, that's it. A prepositional phrase is a group of words which consists of a preposition. So now let us consider each structure one at a time. Let's look into the first structure, and that is none, some, half, more, all, plus the prepositional phrase of the, plus a singular subject or noun will always take a singular verb. So, what is our example sentence? Well, it is all of the stamp is stolen. All of the stamp is stolen. Here the noun subject all is followed by the prepositional phrase of the, and the object of preposition, which in this case is stamp, is singular in number. So we have used singular verb is. Now let us look into the second structure. And our second structure states none, some, half, more, all, plus the prepositional phrase of the, plus a plural noun will take a plural verb. And let us try to understand this structure with the help of another example. And that is, none of the hens are gone. None of the hens are gone. In this sentence, none is followed by the prepositional phrase of the, which is followed by a plural subject, that is hen. And so we have used a plural verb are in the sentence. So isn't that simple for you to remember? That is, noun and pronoun subjects like some, half, none, more or all are followed by prepositional phrase. Then the object of preposition determines the form of the verb. And with that, we have already headed into our practice time. And this is how it works. I will be showing you a sentence, and you know what you have to do? Well, you just have to choose the correct verb that agrees with it. It's as simple as that. So here comes your first sentence. And it states, your pants is are at the cleaners. Your pants is are at the cleaners. Hey, look at the word pants. And what do you think? Which is the correct verb that agrees? And you are certainly right. It is are. Your pants are at the cleaners. Good job. And here comes the next sentence for you. And it states, the family lead very different life in private. The family lead very different life in private. So what do you think about this one? Which is the correct verb that would agree with the collective noun family? I have already given you a hint. So what do you think? Yes, you are so correct. It is leads. The family leads very different life in private. Good job. And here comes your next sentence. And it states, is are the tweezers in this drawer? Is are the tweezers in this drawer? Hey, take a look at the picture of tweezers. What do you think? Have you got your clue? I think you have. And you have already made your choice. And it is the correct one, I guess. And you are right. It is, are the tweezers in this drawer? Great job. So moving on with the next sentence for you. And that is, all of the CDs is are in this case. All of the CDs is are in this case. So what do you think about this sentence? Which is your correct choice of verb? Have you already done it? I think you have. And you have made a great choice. It is are. All of the CDs are in this case. Good one. And here's your next one. And it states, there was were 15 candies in that bag. Now, there is are only one left. So, you have to make two choices in this sentence. So, let us begin with the first one. There were 15 candies in that bag. Now, there is only one left. Good job! Here comes your next one. And it states, $8 is are the price of a movie these days. $8 is are the price of movies these days. So what do you think about this one? Which is the correct choice of verb? Have you got it all right? I guess you have. It is. $8 is the price of a movie these days. You see, dollars is a unit of measurement. Well done. And moving on with the next sentence for you. It is, sleeping under the sun was his favorite pastime. Sleeping under the sun was his favorite pastime. What do you think about this one? Well, you're right again. It is was. Sleeping under the sun was his favorite pastime. Good job. And here comes the last one for you. And it states, Gulliver's Travel is are an interesting novel. Gulliver's Travels is are an interesting novel. So what do you think? Which is the correct verb that would agree with this sentence? And you're so right. It is. You see, it's the name of a novel. And so it takes a singular verb. Great job. Hey, that was really a fantastic job that you have done. I hope you have enjoyed this video and this video has helped you understand the important rules of subject-verb agreement. So you know what, if you have any questions, just pop them in the comment box and I will surely get back to you. So thanks for watching and staying with me till the end of this video. Well, don't forget to like, comment, share, press the bell icon and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. This is Margaret signing off for today. Take care of yourself and bye.